Hello everyone, welcome to SYA Academy. So friends, we are continuing the discussion of creation of immutable classes in Java. So in the last lecture, I created one of the immutable classes in Java, and in that lecture, I talked about how we can create our own customized immutable class, which is having primitive types or some of the objects which are final in themselves. Now the question might come in your mind that how to make a class immutable, which is having dependency on mutable objects. Okay. So before speaking about it, I hope you know what is immutable class. Immutable class is something whose content cannot be changed once it is created. Yeah. So this is a simple definition. If someone is asking you in the interview, and after that they will ask you few examples. Also, you can give the examples like string is one of the examples, and another example. I'm sure they will ask two examples because string is everyone knows about it. Now the other example which you could give is wrapper classes. I hope you know about the wrapper classes, and integer, double, these are the wrapper classes. These are also immutable, so you can give these examples as the immutable classes. Now in the last lecture I talked about how we can create the immutable class. So but that immutable class was using a string internally. Okay, so what I mean to say is let's say if it was a class like employee, then it was having string class as dependencies, or you can say that it didn't have any dependency on any mutable class or dependency on something like employee ID. But employee ID is what? Employee ID is integer. So in employee class has, you can say, as instances or variables which are string and integer. So both of these are immutable. So there was no issue of creation of immutable class. That was comparatively simple. However, now a possibility might be there, or they might ask you in the interview, let's say employee class is there, okay, and that employee class is having dependency on some other class, let's say address class, which is mutable. Mutable means whose content can be changed once it has been initialized or once it has been defined. Okay, so if address is Delhi for some object A, then it could be changed to Bangalore also. Okay, so this is what we call as mutable class. But employee class, if let's say there is one employee class such as one which is employee ID and name is let's say Rahul, then its content cannot be changed. So if E is pointing to this, then E cannot be made to something like this. I hope you are getting my point. This is what we mean about the immutability. Okay. I hope these things are clear. Some of the people were asking how, what is immutability, by giving the example. That's why I gave this example. Now there is a possibility that employee could have the dependency on address. Okay. So one is the employee ID, Rahul is the name, okay, and let's say it is having some address also, and we have initialized the address such as Delhi. Now since Delhi is a class, I mean it is coming from a class which is mutable, so it could be changed to Bangalore also. So that is the disadvantage of having a mutable object. So somehow we need to manage it. Somehow if Delhi has been created once, then it should not be changed to Bangalore, Mumbai or anything else. Okay, so this is what immutability we need to achieve. I hope things are clear to you. If there are any doubts, you can mention in the comment section. And now I am directly presented to you one code. So this is Eclipse, and this is my you can say student class. So let's create a package first. And in this, I am creating one, since the name of the class is student, so I'm creating it as public class. Otherwise, we can have only one public class. So this is a student class. Okay. So let's take some parameters. One of the parameters that what we can say is integer. Student ID. Let's call it roll number, which is a prominent name. So as I told you, integer is in itself immutable class. So there is no issue here. So roll number or roll ID, let's call it roll number. Roll number is having no issue. Now let's say it is having dependency on address also. And what is address? Let's create a class of address also. And the fields in address are something like this. Let's say string city name. Name, and let's say string other name is pin code is also there. Let's keep fields limited to this thing also. And as I told you, address class is made by someone else, or you can say address class is some third party class which is mutable. Okay, so let's make it mutable. So it is having all the getters and setters. Let's create the constructor also. Okay, so you can create the constructor in your way also. Let's create one tool string also so that you are able to see what is going on behind the scenes. So this is how our address class has been created. Since, as I told you, this is a mutable class. We cannot change anything in the address. Okay. So student is having dependency on address class, right? And we want to make student as what? We want to make student as the immutable class, correct? So let's begin the procedure. So first of all, what we will do is we will make the final. Let's write it here. Okay. So and this is giving error because you haven't initialized it in the. Because you haven't initialized in the constructor. So let's create this also. Okay, so it is giving error because I need to write final here. Okay, now it should be fine. Now let's import. Let's create the constructor. So this is the constructor. Okay, so it was giving the error because if you initialize the it with final, then you need to have the constructor. So if I remove the constructor, then see, this is a final word. So final, when you are marking any variable as final, then it has to be initialized. So I could write something like this, then also error will go away, right? I could have something like new address, then also error will go away. Okay, so this is one of the ways also. However, the approach that is generally followed is to have a constructor. Let's make it constructor again. Okay, so keep everything clear. And other things what we will have in the immutable class, what are other things we need to have? We need to have a getter. We will not have any setter. Why will not have any setter? Because setter can change the content of our class. Also, one of the things which is missing here, which you need to remind me, is we need to make this class as final, correct? So that nobody is able to inherit student class and change its content. Okay, that's why we need to make it final. So this is the general procedure that is followed to make the class as immutable. Let me have the to string also. Okay, now let me show you some demo. Let me make a demo test. Okay, let's have public study void main, and what we will have is we will have some address. I hope you are not having any doubts. If you are having any doubts, then please let me know. And pin code is also one string field, right? So we have initialized the address. Now what we will do is make it above. Okay, now I think it will be clear to you. So we have initialized the address. Address is Delhi 110058, which is address of Janakpuri area of Delhi. And now let me create the student object. And let's say this is the student, and let's name it Neha, right? Let's say Neha name student is living in this area, right? So this is giving one error. Okay, no, we don't need to have Neha, we need to have roll number. So roll number 1 is having the address Delhi 110058. Now let's do the sys out for this. And I'm printing S. So what will be the output? I hope everyone knows the output. That output will be So as you can see, the output is here, row number 1, address, and this is Delhi and 1105. So if someone is asking you to build your own immutable class, then you could do something like this. If you don't know the concept, then you might say this is the correct way of building our own immutable class. But after this, your interviewer might do some changes. Changes like a dot set city to Mumbai, right? Now he will ask whether it will give any error or not. You might say yes or no. If you say that it will give some error, then it will create a negative impact. Friends, it will not give any error. Why it will not give any error? Because address is a mutable class. Okay, address is a mutable class. That's why it is not giving any error. I hope this thing is clear to you. Now, what he might do after this is, he might this out S again. Now, what will be the output? What do you think is the output? Think about it for a while and I'm running it again. So, friends, see. The initial value of student was roll number 1, address was Delhi 110058. Now it has been changed. Roll number 1, address is city name Mumbai and pin code is 110058. So immutability of student class has been broken down by this. Now why it is actually happening is because there was one address object which was pointed to Delhi, correct, and pin code was 110058. Now you created one student whose roll number was 1 and it was referencing to this thing. Okay, now friends, what happened after this is someone changed this Delhi to Mumbai. So if you run your sys out again of S, then it will print 1 roll number, and sys address has been changed. So Mumbai and 110058 will be printed. So that's why the answer was coming like that. Now what we can do to avoid this? Friends, to avoid this, what we can do is we can make some changes. Like, let me make the changes with new pen. Let's use red pen. Okay. So what we can do is, if whenever we are using address in the student, then we can create the separate address object. And if someone makes the changes in this, then it will not be affected. So what I'm trying to say is, for student 1, we will create the copy of this. So copy of this will be created and associated with this. Okay, like this. So this one copy has been created and this address has been kept separately. So if someone changes this Delhi to Mumbai, so this address will be affected, but see, this student will not be affected. So this will become immutable. I hope this is clear to you. Let's see how this will be done in our code. So again, if you see the changes that we need to do is, we need to do in student constructor, right? So let's try to do something here. Let's create one new object of the address. And what we will do here is, we will write address dot get city name, correct? Similarly, we will write address dot get pin code. I hope you are getting my point. Now see, A has been created as a separate address. And now we can simply do this dot address is equal to A. Right? I hope this is clear to you. Now friends, if we run it, see my code is same. I haven't made any changes. A dot city name is still changing to Mumbai. And I'm doing this out before this, this out before after this one. So let's try to run it. See friends. Now the output is same. You cannot change your immutable class, which was a student. There is no way of changing it. See, we are not providing any setters, so there is no setter. And if you keep on changing your address, pin code, or city name, or anything else, it will not be affected because we have created a separate address here. See, we have created a separate address, and that address has been associated with your student object. I hope, friends, you understood the concept of building your immutable class, and there won't be any mistakes in the interview. If there are still any doubts, then you can mention it in the comment section. I will answer those questions. And if you like this video, then don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe to SY Academy. And also, if you can help in promoting SY Academy, then it will be grateful. Thank you for watching this. Have a good day.